Pro Life Berks on BCTV is underwritten by Tom Schaefer RV Superstore.
Hi, good evening. Welcome to Pro Life Berks. I'm Kathy Kuhns. I'm co-hosting this program this evening, and I want to wish you all a very Merry Christmas. I hope you're enjoying this time of Advent and of the Christmas season and looking forward to a new year. We want to thank all of you who have been tuning in and watching us this last year. It's such a joy to know that there are people who maybe not always agree with us, but they're willing to listen to our viewpoints and to at least think about some of the things we talk about, which are frequently controversial, we admit, but we think they're needed things that just need to be said and understood to help our community be at peace and to be caring for other people. We need to be a caring community now more than ever with all the COVID that's going around and all the, there's so much unrest and people who have lost their jobs. I mean, there's a lot of suffering in our midst of this joyous time. So just be thoughtful and be thankful. So we have a great program for tonight, as usual. We have two guests, but I'm going to introduce you first to Colin Gordon, who is the co-hosting this evening, and he'll introduce our guests. Colin?
Good evening, everybody. Tonight we have with us Sharon DeAndrea and Robin Ward of LifeSite, of Life Runners. Why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Well, I live in Exeter Township in Reading, and a little bit about myself. I guess I have a family of my husband and my three children. One of my daughters lives in Exeter with us with her three children, and another daughter is in Steubenville, Ohio, with their family of five children. And then
wow.
My
lots of grandchildren.
Yes, we have
we
have eight grandchildren, and
oh,
we are so
goodness.
Proud and excited just to be able to be
oh.
with them and enjoy, you know, babyhood throughout.
Oh, yeah.
Right?
How nice.
And then my son recently graduated from college and is actually working in Norristown at an Amazon plant, or actually different plants at different times. But so that's a little bit about myself. I have been involved in Life Runners only a little under a year because the Reading chapter just started a little under a year ago. So.
And how did you become pro-life?
And how I became pro-life. Well, I think back when Roe v. Wade became law, and I realized I was 8 years old. So I was pretty much sheltered from that as a young child. So I guess as I became more involved in church, in Bible studies and different things, it probably came about more. The subject may have come up more. And then I went to a pro-life, the DC March for Life one year when my children were in high school, I guess. And
uh-huh.
I realized, wow, this is something to become more involved in. There are so many people that are already involved, and this is obviously a huge issue that needs to be addressed. And so that's probably.
So you've been plugging away ever since. I know I've seen you at many events. I know
you're out
there. So.
Right.
So how about you, Robin? How about telling
Thank
us
you.
About yourself?
How I got involved in pro-life is I have to give a lot of credit to Sharon. She was a big influence to me years ago when I was on the fence about the issue.
Uh-huh.
And at around the same time, my spiritual journey was leading me to become born again. So that created a big heart change.
Uh-huh.
And I saw the need to support pro-life causes and even become an activist.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. And how about yourself? Do you have a family?
I have a a wonderful husband. I live in Boyertown, a grown daughter, a dog and a cat.
No grandchildren yet.
And I'm just enjoying the retired life, teaching fitness classes, and I have wonderful opportunities to do use my keyboard skills.
Oh, you're a musician?
Yes.
And a musician, yes.
Oh.
Wonderful musician.
Wow.
Oh, and Sharon and I.
Her. Yes, we do a sing-along together.
My best friend Sharon,
they
yes.
do a sing-along.
So we do a lot of things
yes.
together.
So it, we you know. May yes. December next year.
Oh, maybe.
We need to have a musical program. We love to have music at
song.
Christmas. So
yes,
if had
true.
We known you were
that's
so musical,
true.
We would have.
I said we should have brought your keyboard,
program,
Robin.
But, you know,
okay.
Can't do everything.
Yeah.
But life runners, this is quite an interesting topic, which I know almost nothing about. So
yeah, and we're kind of right there with you, Kathy.
Yeah.
We're learning, right? Mm-hmm. It's very new. It's new to this area, but they have been around since 2008 is when I guess it began, and the founder, and he's a doctor, Pat Castle. He's the one who actually ran a race at Pikes Peak and was able to finish it. And that's kind of where the story began. And then I guess it was then 2 years later when this all evolved into his mission.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
well, that's the only thing I read was his story because he's retired Air Force, so I had
that's
to read
quite
that.
The,
but he,
quite the running event.
Yes.
Pikes
yeah.
Peak. Yeah.
He,
that's right.
He mm-hmm. finished early, 5 minutes early than his record.
Okay.
And what was spurring him on was this voice behind him, a cloudy day, couldn't see who it was, but he heard this voice behind him saying, 10 minutes, you're almost there. 5 minutes, you're almost there. Keep
you
it up,
do
you're
it.
Almost there.
Right, you can do it.
And turned around, of course, he never saw the person. Well, so as soon as he got finished, collapsed, recovered, called his mother, and his mother said, oh, thank goodness you're okay. She said at 10 of 3, this is at 3 o'clock, he got to the race. She said at 10 of 3, she said, I just had this foreboding feeling, and so I asked Padre Pio to be there with you
so he, yes,
for the race.
She asked for intercessory
so they,
prayer.
So he concluded that was Padre
Pio,
Pio's
that,
voice. Exactly. And, you know, Padre Pio was one of the fabulous saints of the Catholic Church. Mm-hmm. He could bilocate. He could
right.
actually go to different locations mm-hmm. while he was still alive in his regular body. Don't ask me how. It's incredible.
Yes. Yeah.
So he was so in awe of knowing that Padre Pio had been with him mm-hmm. and helped with this. That was one of the reasons.
That's
that
right.
he started, I don't know yes. what he did after that. I just mm-hmm. read that part.
Mm-hmm. No.
But very interesting.
How did the two of you become interested in life runners? Are you runners yourself, or is it just something that you've seen in your community? You said you teach fitness classes. Is
yes.
it something?
Yeah.
That,
and by the way, Colin's a runner.
And
that's
yes,
right.
we know Colin is a runner.
You're a long distance runner, right?
Mm-hmm. Not as long distance as I used to, but yeah. Oh, yeah.
But sure. he was our guest last month, if any of you tuned in and saw this familiar face. But I think you run like 5 to 10 miles a day. Isn't that what you
yeah.
told us?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh, my gosh.
Padre
I can't
Pio.
Even walk
I can't say Padre Pio's ever run with me, but unfortunately.
Yeah, that's but, amazing.
So how did you become yeah. interested in the group?
So do you want me to start?
Yep.
So I have a very good friend, Elizabeth Laskowski, who put out a general email to our Bible study group, and she had mentioned that it was on her heart to start this, and I saw a new year, because I believe it was in January, knowing I needed to do something, you know, as like a resolution for the new year, and thinking, here it is, I can involve myself more with the pro-life movement and also get exercise and just be with people. And I thought of Robin because she is just so into staying healthy and fit, and also my pro-life friend. And so I believe I mm-hmm. asked mm-hmm. if you wanted to join
in. And that's what
in.
I love about Life Runners, that it involves the fitness part of it.
Right.
But for anybody interested in becoming a member, it's just simply being able to spare 1 hour once a month, first Wednesdays at 3:30, to join us on a witness walk to Planned Parenthood in Reading, where we pray. And we've also added an extra hour on the second, on the third weekend of every month to walk at various public locations, and then we can include those who are working.
Oh, right. So do you say, so you're walking, you're not actually running?
That's right. It's in our name.
So that anybody can do this.
We're working up to
Yes, we're working up to running, okay. And we're actually thinking that Colin could really train us for a big marathon race or something. Because part of the life runners, and I'm being totally serious, part of life runners is there are many, multiple throughout the year, runs that they will open up, obviously, and then encourage the life runner chapters to either sign up for, and it could be that one person from the chapter signs up or multiple. Just this past year they had a cross country, I think from California maybe to New York.
And
they so all the chapters were aware of this, and Elizabeth actually signed us up to do a certain, I think it was a two miles that she kind of plotted out around the same area that we normally walk, but she added some more.
In conjunction with it nationally.
Right, in conjunction nationally, and I think she signed us up for the certain day and time. And so we were part of the miles that were run.
And then, that's nice.
You know, you could actually travel out to the place where the route was and be part of the route, actually.
But where do you actually, where are you walking or running now?
So right now, on the first Wednesdays, we meet near Albright College.
Richland Street, isn't it?
Is it Richland? Richland, yes,
or
North
Rockland?
Richland. Or anyway, we meet... We can always be clear about that if anyone's interested, but it's very close to Albright, and then we have a certain route we take, and then we walk towards the new Planned Parenthood spot.
On Kutztown Road.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yes. And then
so this is the third Wednesday of the month?
First Wednesday. And at 3:30.
3:30, okay.
We meet and walk.
And how many are there other people besides the two of you?
There are. Some actually do it on their own in their own neighborhood for reasons that they can't meet us at that time. Maybe someone in the family is needing attention and they couldn't meet us.
Or support us in prayer.
They support in prayer.
Wear their shirts.
Yes, a big part of
I love
it
the shirt.
Is, it's very bright.
The back?
So, it's very, sure, we'll show the back, too.
Show the back. Remember the unborn, Jeremiah 1:5, liferunners.org. How nice, really nice, that really shows up. You don't have to say anything, people know what you're about when you
wear
those.
And,
that's
and now that it's getting colder, we were happy to find on their gear to purchase some vests. That we plan to put over our coats so that even though in the winter when we're doing our walk, we'll still be recognized as life runners.
Yeah.
So we're glad.
That's good. I want to put a plug in for Elizabeth because if any of you have been following us along over the years, we actually had Elizabeth Laskowski on twice. And the first time she talked about the pregnancy to help get people who need infertility.
Yes,
she talked about that, and then and she was very, very worked very hard in that area. And then the second time we had her on with her husband, and they talked about some of her. She has what, five children?
I think she has six. Actually. Yeah.
And some of them were adopted. And that very night of our program, they were going to meet the social worker. And have their last child. They were going to meet their last child who was coming in as foster care, but they were hoping, like with the other ones, that they would be able to adopt. So there are very strong, strong witnesses for adoption. Adoption just is not mentioned enough in the pro-life movement. And there's not nearly enough adoptions going on. Sad to say, and I know I've mentioned this several times, I've been doing pro-life, very actively pro-life for 23 years, and I only know a handful of a handful of adoptions in all that time. Mm-hmm. It's just not acceptable. It's difficult. I mean, you know, you still have to go through a pregnancy, and most women feel, well, after they go through the pregnancy, they don't want to give up the child, but yet, you know, what's the alternative? You certainly don't want to kill your child. So we want to put a big plug in and thank Elizabeth if she's tuning in now. I know she's moved, so I don't know whether she'll still get to see the program.
She's in North Carolina, but I'm sure she'll be able to see it.
We want to put, she's done a lot of great things, just really a great witness for the pro-life movement. And we want to thank her for that. And we also want to continue her plug and her encouragement of others to do adoption, because it's just... adoption is a wonderful option. There's just no question about it. Then it's a win-win for everyone. Mm-hmm. And just not, and the thing of it is, if there's anyone out there who's pregnant, who's on the fence, whether they want to have abortion or maybe they would consider keeping their child, let me tell you, and I know these girls can tell you, there is plenty of help available. You're not alone whatsoever, and you won't be alone. If you decide you want to keep that baby, the help will come. There's no question.
Yes, that's right. Mm-hmm.
So please consider that, especially at this time of year, that is so special. Yeah. Mm-hmm. That really, you know, makes us focus on the gift of life and the gift of an infant. Mm-hmm. Just too precious, and it's such a gift that, you know, many people who can't have children realize how special and wonderful and miraculous it is to have a child. And yet those who don't maybe think they wouldn't be a good mother or don't want them, not so much. Mm-hmm. So, but the fact is, a new life is a brand new life, and it's a precious, small but mighty gift for you. So think about adoption if you're pregnant, please. And you can go, we have plenty of pro-life centers in our area. You can go to Lifeline over in West Reading. You can go to CareNet right on Fifth Street, right up the street, down across from the library. Mary's Shelter, which is over on across from the state police. There's a crisis center up in Kutztown and up in Hamburg. Mm-hmm. Did I get them all? Don't think I've missed any. But they're all, you know, they may not be open 24/7, but they all have numbers you can call and get tuned in. And if you're out of the Berks County area, if you live up near the Lehigh Valley, there's
Mary's Shelter, are you thinking about?
No, there's a crisis pregnancy center. I know they just changed their name and I can't remember their name. Anyway, just all you got to do is Google pro-life or pregnancy help, and there's a wonderful place in Ephrata. There's several places in Lancaster.
I believe Pottstown has Genesis.
You are not alone, and you won't be. Through your pregnancy, there'll be somebody to walk with you through that whole experience. And if you do want to go for adoption, there's Catholic Charities, there's other groups. We've done one or two programs on adoption, and it's really worth your consideration. So, sorry to get off the track there, but we always have to put these plugs in.
That's right.
So you were saying how you both decided to start in this, Life Runners.
Right. And it really started out for our chapter as a Life Walkers, but we are going to hopefully incorporate some jogging into our walks or our route, and then those who don't want to jog that do meet with us, we can certainly walk those days, or do half and half if we have enough people, you know, mm-hmm. to do both. And then the joggers will just have to wait for us at
that's the right.
Planned Everybody at their own pace.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right. Yeah.
So, oh, that's great.
So anyway, we...
So tell us a little more about Life Walkers. How large is it and where are they and everything?
Well...
You have some information on
I
that?
I do, actually. I just wanted to share. I thought this was kind of interesting. Dr. Pat had started this, I guess, 2 years after that one Pikes Peak run. And in 2008, there were 12 teammates from 4 states.
Oh.
And then the next year, 2009, there were 12 teammates from 4 states. And then in 2010, there were 17 teammates from 5 states. Today, there are over 17,600 teammates. We are in 41 nations and
wow.
are located in 2,178 cities. So
wow, that has it, grown.
It has
That's
grown
incredible.
Quite amazingly, yeah.
Well, I met a girl, maybe 2-3 years ago in Allentown that was a life runner. And I didn't know anything about the group at the time, but she was by herself. But then I met someone else who said there's another group in Philadelphia that's very active.
Yes. Well, they're all over. And in fact, we were at the very first PA March for Life in Harrisburg.
Uh-huh. On September,
in
right?
September, we and ran into quite a few other life runners. We wore our shirts.
Oh, yes.
Wore
our shirts.
We got a lot of attention.
Yeah. We got a lot of attention.
People wanted to interview us.
And yes, we were interviewed.
We were very surprised.
You know, a radio station, I presume, from the area. Yeah. But it was very exciting just to think that you're part of a group that is so big.
Yeah.
You see them other places. In fact, in talking with people, like, oh, yeah, we saw you at this run. And I said, well, we were never at that run. We don't run, don't you know? No. But then we realized that what they were seeing were other chapters that were participating in that run and holding up big banners or whatever. So when we were in Harrisburg, right behind
us,
up on the hill,
on the steps.
The steps of the,
Of the Capitol.
Yeah, was a huge Life Runner sign.
Yes,
I saw that. Right.
So I went up to talk with them and just let them know, hey, this is great. Nice to meet you kind of thing. And they acted as though we were their sisters when we met anyone, anyone that saw us, trust us. So we felt like family, which was really kind of neat. It was really, really
nice.
Neat. And we also were greeted with a lot of help. Hey, if you ever want to do a run, you just let me know. We'll work it out. We'll try. Mm-hmm. So so there are a lot of chapters that are more into the running aspect of it.
And this is something for guys to do, too.
Absolutely.
Because there's so much they can't do. I mean, it really, counseling, it's just naturally women to women. But do you have any men?
Well, there's a name on our chapter of a man, and I don't know anything about that man. It's just recently popped up, so I might need to do a little research and find out. But there have been the husbands of some of the wives that have talked about it, and not that have joined in yet, but that doesn't mean that they won't come along at some point. I don't know.
That's great. You interested, Colin?
Yeah, potentially.
Colin.
Yes,
as long as we run, right?
You
Colin?
Could you could lead the you could lead the charge with your conditioning.
There you go.
Right.
Be the grand marshal.
I think I wanted to mention too that so in Pennsylvania, I noticed there. Where did I say? Okay, so there's only 3 chapters in PA. One being Reading, one Philadelphia, and then one in Nazareth.
Yeah.
Those are the 3
in PA.
They are pretty close. We need some in Pittsburgh and other places. So, you know, if you happen to be tuning in right from Pittsburgh.
Yeah.
Hey.
Let's get something going.
Are you planning to go to the march in Washington?
January? If I am in town, I'm not positive I will be.
Because that would be a good place to wear your shirts or
your
vests that you're getting.
Absolutely. Our vests,
yeah. Yes.
I might need to get some caps like you have.
Yeah.
That actually, right? A Life Runner's cap would be actually actually a good idea. That's something to think about.
Yeah.
So
and that is such a wonderful event. Sharon got me hooked on going to that. Maybe a dozen years ago.
Yeah, that's coming up. We should mention that. January 22nd.
It's a Friday,
it's
I know.
It's a Friday. Fridays are bad. The traffic's bad coming home, but other than that.
Well, usually get to ride on the bus.
There are a lot of buses.
There's a Boyertown bus from Boyertown.
Boyertown.
Our dear friend Candy organized.
Conception, St. Ignatius. And then there's St. Benedict's with Helen. Helen Min always organizes a bus. So we have good, and there's I know there's at least one bus from Allentown, maybe two, if anybody lives over that way. But I'm not going this year. Yeah. I went last year, but I can't. My
it's
knees
hard on the knees,
can't,
right?
Can't do it. So I don't
know what I'll be doing.
I'll be there in spirit. I'll be down, probably down at Planned Parenthood praying, but I don't know.
I'll just put this out there, but when my teenage daughter in high school went as a youth group, we ended up spending the whole time pushing someone in a wheelchair that we had no idea who they were. So that's always an option. I'm just putting it out
there. It is. I know. I know.
So someday.
I know. I'll have to think about it. But I've only missed twice in 20 years.
Wow.
I mean,
wow,
And that was one was a snowstorm and the other one. I did have a physical problem, so I haven't missed much.
And it is, I guess I was surprised my first time going. I wasn't sure what the spirit of it was going to be, what to expect.
Such a blessing.
It was so joyous.
Yes.
And all the young people just being on fire, and they made it fun with their cheers
And a few times
the wonderful speeches.
Yes.
Just seeing what. Tens of thousands hundreds of thousands marching.
Several times I was able to go down the night before and sleep on the in the basement of the cathedral.
At the cathedral.
And they have mass and rosary all night, and it's just hundreds of sleeping bags and kids and feet. And that is so, oh my goodness, so exciting.
Yes.
So yeah, that's a good place to get your message out.
Yes.
So,
right.
Okay. Let's see. What do you think, Colin? What would you like to ask him? Anything special?
Yeah. How do you think fitness, since it's not specifically running, fits into the pro-life message? Like, something that I always got out of training was suffering, and in some weird way, I always felt that if I could suffer, even though it's self-inflicted, I was sharing in other suffering. Because we have such
That's
comfortable lives, you know what I mean?
We do have very comfortable lives.
We almost have to
right.
seek suffering. Yeah. And,
Well, I think that's a really interesting point to even bring up the suffering. I think you're right. We do live in a world where, I mean, you even look at COVID and the flu. Let's look at the flu. We go and get a shot because we don't want to suffer through the flu. Now, some people could get very sick and have very serious medical, you know, concerns with the flu, but I certainly would get a shot so that I would spare myself, hopefully spare myself from a, you know, being sick in bed for 4 or 5 days, right? So we do. We're you know, instantaneous. We like to have our food right through that drive-through window. There's so much out there that we have these comforts, right? Comforts of oftentimes.
And I would say too, looking at it biblically, the Lord has given us these. You know, our bodies are a temple with what we put into it. You know, physically, spiritually, and also I feel like we have an obligation to the Lord to take care of these, our marvelous bodies. So that would be even in the fitness realm.
Right, and so. Taking care of it sometimes can be painful when you're training and running and pushing yourself, right?
But also a deep satisfaction with that too,
and
right?
And you think that discipline.
And overcoming, because then that even relates to other challenges in life. That and sometimes I even feel like being physically strong helps make you mentally strong too.
Yeah, absolutely.
Just translates into other realms.
And just, you know, thinking about being outside, I always thought I really need to get more fresh air. And I think it does. It helps you clear your mind. It helps you think a little more.
And gets you in the moment too, as opposed to just being distracted by so many other things out there.
Yeah, that's
oh, those are all great
true.
Points. I hadn't thought about the
good question.
Self-discipline
good question.
Part of it, really. That's another way to you know.
So I guess we got to start suffering a little more, Robin, and start running.
But also the concept of redemptive suffering. You can suffer and offer that for others.
I was thinking about the whole opus dei spirituality.
That's a wonderful.
Right.
I mean, for me, that would be suffering.
That's true.
Even to be walking a lot.
All right, so you're walking with us the next month,
but I mean, look at these people that go to like, the great monasteries and mm-hmm. centers and walk on their knees.
On their knees, you know, up the marble
suffering.
Steps
and
or
so,
something.
Mm-hmm. You know, what's a 5-mile walk, right?
Right.
A piece of walk in the
or
park.
Or a 1-mile walk with us on Wednesdays, right?
Yeah. Is that what it is, a
it
mile?
Is only about it's only about a mile,
right.
I think.
That's right.
Yeah,
oh,
mile's good, yeah.
Yeah, it's about 45 minutes, and sometimes, you know, with prayer and socializing a little bit before we begin, and of course, we're always talking while we're walking, and sometimes we're praying while we're walking, too, as well.
You can pray the rosary while you're walking.
We have done that, and some Divine Mercy, some chaplets, and
and what is the prayer that we actually say?
Would you wanna say it with me?
Yeah.
Because I did write it. Where did I?
Oh, you have
write
a prayer?
Did you write it vaguely? I don't have my greeting glasses.
So there's actually a creed.
The creed.
There's actually a creed. I have two of them right here. Oh. That's even larger print than this one. So what we do is once we get to the Planned Parenthood area, we will pray together the creed. And this is specifically put together from the Life Runners organization. I'm sure Dr. Pat was, you know, either put this together all himself or as a group he was part of this. Mm-hmm. And it goes like this. We believe in the dignity of all human life from conception to natural death. We run as a prayer to defend children in the womb so that they may be born and united with our Christian community. We run to build endurance, for the race is long, and we must keep our eyes fixed on you, Lord. We run for awareness, so our culture will view all human life as a reflection of your glory, Lord. We run for charity
to
provide support for mothers and fathers tempted to abort their child and healing support for post-abortion women, men, and families. We run to end abortion, for Christ died so that all may live. Guard us all, born and unborn, with your peace, Lord. For in you, life is victorious. We pray and run in your name, Jesus Christ, amen.
Oh, that's beautiful. I love your baby, too.
So this particular baby, his name was Waylon, I believe. This is something that I received recently from the Life Runners email that I received. And this baby was a saved baby, specifically because of Life Runners. The mother must have been speaking with someone, and she shared that this baby was diagnosed to have Down syndrome before he was born, and the father threatened to leave unless the baby was aborted.
Oh.
So the mother saw a Remember the Unborn yard sign, which inspired her to choose life, and baby Waylon doesn't even have Down syndrome, which is often the case, often something to think about when, you know, they say that this baby will have a defect, and I've had even a good friend that I heard was also in the same position of being told her baby would most probably have Down syndrome. Mm-hmm. Now, it does say here baby Waylon doesn't have Down syndrome. He is perfectly made with or without Down syndrome. So even with Down syndrome,
still be perfect. Right.
He is a perfect baby. And and I'll tell you, there are so many that are blessings that have Down syndrome.
Oh, absolutely.
And yes, just so many. In fact, my daughter has a brother-in-law with Down syndrome, and he's just wonderful. And there's just so much that every child has to potentially bring
and
to
a purpose.
Life.
Yes.
And a purpose in life,
that's right. No matter what level
sometimes the purpose is to bring out the sympathy that we have deep inside, that if we didn't have those challenges in front of us, to bring that out in us, mm-hmm. what kind of world would we really be? Look at all of the people that, when there's a you know, a disaster, that they are right there mm-hmm. helping, right? Mm-hmm. So that's the spirit. That's the spirit not only of people, but, or I should say, not only of Americans, but of all people mm-hmm. is what we're created for, right? For,
mm-hmm. for absolutely. That. Love one and, another.
Yes. So one of the things they did, this baby Waylon, they gave the mother and child a $300 gift card and then sent them some team gear as well. So, aww. You know, they do help. Mm-hmm. Right. There's many other ways they right. help, but this particular one,
that's wonderful.
They knew the, yeah. you know, the fruits of, you know, having that sign out and this. I guess I could also mention what the shirt stands for.
I was mm-hmm. going to ask you yeah. that, Jeremiah 1:5. Tell yeah. us about that. Mm-hmm.
Here's my little notes here. So the dove represents the Holy Spirit bringing power and healing and peace. Uh-huh. And then, of course, we're runners, uh-huh. and that's meant to represent meeting mothers in need of healing to prevent
neat.
Abortion, racing to cross the finish line that ends abortion. So that's another what the
neat.
Running is all about. And then you see the cross here. And of course, the cross is, it just represents Christ. So mm-hmm. all in Christ for pro-life. The Jeremiah 1:5 proclaims God's word, which is, before I formed you in the womb, I knew you.
Uh-huh.
So remember the unborn is their kind of motto, right?
Do you know who designed that, how that came about? Was that done by the
founder? I have a feeling it was.
Very thoughtful.
It's very,
yeah.
and I like the coloring, too. The bright white just really helps it stand out. And
yeah.
I think that's what we need. We need to kind of stand out in a crowd and
right. Mm-hmm.
so that people notice what you're about here.
Yep.
Yeah. Anyway,
yeah.
Something I also picked off of their the website was 78% of post-abortion women said if one person, like one life runner, had offered support, or if they viewed a supportive sign like our Remember the Unborn gear, they would have chosen life. So that's huge.
Mm-hmm.
70, and it also mm-hmm. makes you realize that those that are going for their abortion on the abortion days, you know, how important it is to be a sign there for them. So
mm-hmm.
It's very hard in our lives being mm-hmm. as active and working and all the things that are there for us, but any spare moment could save a life,
mm-hmm. that's right.
and often does, mm-hmm. right? And
yeah,
Kathy, you would know that for
yeah.
sure.
I mean, most
yeah.
women going in there feel in some way that they don't have an option. They just
right.
feel that,
right.
that they're
and
alone,
and
mostly it's financial,
the
or they may have a boyfriend pushing them to say, you know, I'm mm-hmm. going to leave you, like,
right.
you know?
Yes, like
mm-hmm.
this particular
so
case.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
so, absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we can't stress that enough, and we did. We've had this topic several times. We've had post-abortion women on, and
mm-hmm.
and we've had a Trish Scafani. That's another, like Rachel's Vineyard for Catholic mm-hmm. groups, mm-hmm. but open to anybody.
Mm-hmm.
But Trish Scafani started a group locally at Green Valley Church, I think it is, and Spring Valley. I'm sorry,
Spring Valley.
And for post-abortion counseling, and you know, that's 78%. That's a very fair
and I would
number.
Imagine a lot of the women think
yeah.
this is just an easy solution,
yeah.
and they'll over and done
yes,
with.
Yes,
no further, but then it can haunt them, and they can have so many
right.
great
it's
regrets.
It's not the answer,
later,
and it's not a simple answer.
Right.
That's for sure.
That's right.
Yeah. So, have you had any feedback from anyone on the street?
Well, we've not had any negative reaction.
No negatives.
No negatives.
I mean, there have been some positive responses and also some questioning about our
that's
purpose.
That's good. Okay.
But the lack of negative responses is very encouraging to me.
Oh, absolutely.
Because I think that many people are fearful about being vocal about the issue.
Right.
But I think they are silently supportive.
Yeah. Right. Right. Oh, absolutely.
Right. And I guess, and that's good, we need prayer, but we also need to be more of a presence, I think.
Right.
And so that did happen to us yesterday at the, yes. We went to a Coventry mall to,
we were.
Sharon and I
right.
were able
met,
to make
you
it.
You met Christine.
Yeah, yes, that's right. And Tom, the other ladies weren't able to join
were
us
you
this
there
time.
Too? With your mom?
I was not.
No.
No.
They met.
Yeah.
Shopping
Colin's
isn't
mom.
Your thing?
Nope. We were led. We were. Your mom was led
so
to
strange.
Us. It was so
that, yeah, she emailed
so
me. She said, I'm at the mall and I met these.
But we did. There was a gentleman that actually came to us to tell us he liked our shirts.
Like
and
to,
then
and
we got engaged
really
in
nice
conversation
why were you,
with him.
Were you just there shopping or were you there?
No, we were walking.
Our purpose was to do this third weekend, walk out in public.
Oh,
yeah.
How
so we did the
nice
whole perimeter of the mall
yes,
and the stores and
inside the perimeter.
So it was
of
very
the mall.
That was wonderful that he came to tell us that he liked our shirts and then we had a nice talk.
And then
about
of course Robin and I wanted our picture taken in front of some big mural and so another guy and we're trying to do a selfie, you know, of us doing
very
and
kind
he came
man,
up, he came up and so we're it's nice because we're able to start conversations with people and you just never know. Whose life you're going to
that's right.
You don't know. Effect. Oh, that is so nice. Do you do that every month?
Yes. So every, we've decided just recently, the last maybe 3 months.
Because we had quite a few ladies who wanted to support, you know, be in the group, but are working during the day, couldn't come to the witness walk on the Wednesday. So, so they're able to. We had a group of 6 or 7 the other last month to walk at
a park
in Douglasville. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So we try and mix it up a little bit.
Different locations.
We also try and make it in places where strollers are able to, you know, some of the parks have nice paved walkways and then of course malls obviously are good places to bring
now,
strollers.
Christmas.
So and we also figured if anyone wanted to do a little last minute shopping, that would be the great place. We'll do a walk and they can go off and shop afterwards. So
that's perfect.
So we're trying to be thoughtful with our with our places to join. But it's the idea is and the big part is, you know, one of the things that they say here is we need to witness with Remember the Unborn jerseys. Which impacts hearts and minds for saving lives. So they say running optional, jerseys required. So we certainly took running optional very seriously. Mm-hmm. And we have not really done that yet. But
one of our new members is a runner, so we we want
say,
to try
to
hello build
out
up,
there.
Build
we
up
need,
a bit.
You need to recruit
need some more
runners.
Mm-hmm. Yes, some actual
some
runners.
Guys. This and is such a wonderful opportunity.
Well, Colin's going to join us.
Because
I can feel
Colin
it.
Said he would.
I mean, a silent Christian, you know, a man with a message.
Right. Mm-hmm.
That's really powerful.
Oh, you're right. Mm-hmm. That's right.
I mean, he's not out there to hurt anybody, and he just wants to tell you, you know, he's got a message of love, really.
Mm-hmm.
And,
got
to get some guys in your group. There's no question about it. Mm-hmm. But it's so cool. And that's my other question. Is there an age limit either way, young or old?
Because it could.
It could be any.
Elizabeth used to bring her children and the
all
other friends.
Newborns and all sorts anything, all the way up to... You know, over 100.
I guess we could have dogs too.
You know, and again, you know, I think pushing a wheelchair gives not only
you know talk about you know suffering that would be
that could really make you struggle up some
gosh,
of those hills,
right?
So you know, anybody can do this, and then if you have a wheelchair, I'm willing.
Sure.
I've done it before.
Yeah.
Oh, that's neat.
But so. I guess one of the things, if we could show any of the pictures, would that be
we forgot about the pictures. Yes, you want to put those up, and well, you can talk
maybe
about
maybe I can explain a little
up.
Bit. Of,
yeah.
So
yeah.
This first picture happens to have Elizabeth Laskowski, who started this chapter. You'll see her with two of her children. Robin and I are in there too, and then there's a church friend and pretty close neighbor. Julie Wright and her daughter also. And so that was one of our walks near Albright and Planned Parenthood area. Mm-hmm. And then Here Robin is displaying the back of her vest.
And now, candy.
Now Robin was
the
great
vests.
To,
they're nice.
She mm-hmm. was great to purchase a bunch of vests. So anyone who doesn't uh-huh. have a t-shirt is welcome to come, or a jersey. Mm-hmm. They're welcome to come and we can let them borrow those. And then if they decide they want to continue and, you know, are encouraged and able to buy a jersey, then they can buy a jersey, and mm-hmm. and that'll help us in the wintertime too, be more recognizable.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And then this one, I happen to be in my prep class, and my prep class yeah. holds their lesson days on Wednesdays. So every uh-huh. first Wednesday, in fact, the girl that's in between, or in the middle there, her mother is part of our Life Runners group, also Miranda is as well, but we decided to wear our Life Runner shirts to prep class and every first Wednesday, because that's the day that we do things. Mm-hmm. So every first Wednesday we're going to be wearing our Life Runner shirts. And then the mm-hmm. next one, this is us at the mall,
yeah.
the latest.
Here we are.
Our latest, yeah, I look uh-huh. like I have a suntan or something. Mm-hmm. Right?
Well, that's a good picture.
Yeah.
So Rob and I are at the mall. And we just wanted to show you how we kind of go different places.
Yeah.
And then this is the Miranda and her mother and sister that, right, you'll notice the crosses, the ash crosses uh-huh. on their forehead. That was Ash Wednesday. Ash Wednesday was the first
t-shirts?
Wednesday.
Are
there are two different colors.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Yep, there are. There's all. They have all sorts of gear. In fact,
and I hats,
yes, they have all sorts of like
oh. pants,
I think, and scarves, and yes, oh, I have the Life Runners sweatpants, mm-hmm. and they have jackets, uh-huh. all sorts of things. So you know, obviously, mm-hmm. you don't have to wear them just on the first Wednesdays. You can wear them anytime mm-hmm. you want,
and right.
oh, and, right. and that would probably be encouraged as well. But I think that's all the, you know,
okay.
the pictures.
Oh, mm-hmm. that's interesting. Yeah. Good yeah. pictures.
Yeah.
So, would you like to offer the website where people can get in contact
I
with
will.
You?
So, it's. Did you want to add something?
No.
You're saying
no.
Okay.
Meaning the app, is that what?
Well, no.
The
liferunners.org. Yeah. So, it's basically www.liferunners.org.
One word.
And, yeah.
Okay. www.liferunners.org.
Okay, they can
easy.
Go there, and then you will, if you want to join a team, you see the tab for join, and then it'll take you right through. You'll pick the chapter. So Reading, if you're from this area, you would pick the Reading chapter, and then I will probably receive an email letting me know that somebody has, joined from our area. And then another way, if you wanted to just ask me more questions about it, mm-hmm. you can certainly email me at rvwish85@aol.com.
You want to repeat that?
That's, yes, and I'll do Robert Victor William Igloo Susan for Sharon. And Harvey, 85@aol.com.
Okay.
So rvwish85@aol.com. And that's another way just to get in touch
again?
With me. The website for Life Runners is www.liferunners.org. And again, there are tons of things to click on. You could, there's audio, like videos that you can listen to or watch, and then audio that you can listen to of different things that this Dr. Pat has been involved in, and explaining how it all got started. You know, uh-huh. you
is there to... like a magazine or a weekly pep talk or?
I do get emails, and uh-huh. I've passed on some mm-hmm. Of the emails, but not all of them. But we're new to this too, because mm-hmm. we've only been doing it pretty much the two of us. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. heading it for, mm-hmm. I think, 3 months
right.
now? About
right.
3 months, yeah, mm-hmm. because I think it was September that we met with Elizabeth the last time, mm-hmm. I believe.
Right.
So,
mm-hmm.
November, December, yep. Mm-hmm. Not even 3 months.
Mm-hmm. And are there any other groups like this in the, around the country that you know? Any other runner groups?
Well, when we were in Harrisburg, Oh, you mean like Life Runners?
Oh, yeah. Or, but called something different.
Oh,
like called something else. I mean, it's such I'm a good idea. Sure. I wondered if
there were if other there were similar
other parts of the country. Or
I believe there are.
Are there? Okay.
I can't say a specific group, but okay. There are certainly other faith-based running groups.
Hmm. Okay, yeah. Right. Not necessarily with
because I know there's a bicycle group, Rich Bainco, right. Who's he goes off on these trips where they sponsor bikers.
Right.
And then they go, like, I think he was supposed to last summer go cross country. I don't know that they ever did.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
But they go on long trips, like a week or two at a time.
Right, right.
And then they plan it. They have a leader, and that person gets a church to put them up.
Okay.
You know, they have sleeping bags.
Right.
And then they have families feed them.
Wow. Yeah,
so
that's
it
really
doesn't
neat.
Cost anything. And that's then really they before they leave, they go around and get sponsors.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And then they raise money for whatever the cause is. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You know,
and that is something that Life Runners does too. So even if you don't want to necessarily join right now in the spirit of giving at Christmas time, certainly don't making a donation. If you go to the website, you can actually find a donation place as well. Mm-hmm. But one of the things that if we do become involved in marathons or runs, certain runs, we would probably get sponsors and that money then would be used and sent over as well. And they do, that. You know, just buying gear helps them too, for sure.
Oh yeah, to have for people who can't afford it, that would be neat.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's a really nice, that's great.
Yeah, good Christmas gift idea, right?
So
people that have everything.
That's right.
Do
you feel more physically fit since you started?
Sure. Well, I don't know that I can say that. I actually wanted to walk faster at the mall so that I could get my heart rate up a little bit. But Robin was feeling a little dizzy that day, right? So she said, "Oh, can we just take it a little slower?" So anyway,
So people actually stopped and asked you and.
Yep, and engaged. Yeah, we have that even on our walks, you know, around Albright and going to Planned Parenthood. We've had people stop and engage with us, and it's great. It's great to be able to you know, just speak what we're doing. We've not had anyone negatively speak to us or speak at us, I should say. Mm-hmm. Everyone's been, you know, very kind and. Anyway, so we're
I mean, there's so many opportunities. I'm thinking all the fairs and the sports
places.
I mean, there's so many
where
places.
There's big groups of
And as we grow,
and you don't have to do anything. You just have to walk.
We just have to walk around. That's right.
Yeah.
That's right. Oh, it's it's really awesome to be part of a group where they have their own gear that you can, you know, make known something that's so very important. But I think in, you know, helping people to maybe think about this more seriously in their own lives, I would just offer that, you know, maybe give it a chance. We do have the new year coming up, so it's a good time to make a resolution.
Everybody makes their New Year's resolution.
That's right. Yeah. Maybe this could be your New Year's resolution. And, you know, if you're going to be resolute about joining, it's only an hour and a half a month.
I was going to say, there's no penalty if you don't show up.
No.
You don't. It's not fixed in stone that you have to be there every week.
Which
is nice too, because everybody's busy. And you know, but still, you could fit this in, and everybody needs to exercise. So
that's right.
Here's
that's right. And the fresh air, because I think we're cooped up inside too much these last couple of years. We need to get out and. Just breathe, you know, fresh life into us.
Well, it's been a pleasure to have you. This has just been so interesting, and I know this is
so
new.
Much.
This is new to a lot of people because I barely heard anything about it, and I try to keep up with what's going on. I mean, I knew that Elizabeth had started that group,
right?
Mm-hmm. But I didn't know the details.
And we're trying
to
carry on that tradition.
And we're so happy to do that.
Yes.
Actually,
So, I hope that what's his name, the colonel that retired, who started this.
Oh, the doctor, Dr. Pat.
Yeah. what's his name? Anyway, Dr. Yeah. Pat, we'll call him.
Pat Castle.
I hope you get to have him here locally sometime. That would be a neat. Mm. That would be an event in itself.
He is a speaker. And
to have him come, because I think he really would appeal to guys. I mean, mm-hmm. it just struck.
I think we would have to have a real major run though for him to want to just show up, because he's a runner.
Yeah.
But Colin can help us with that if he's engaged
in Philadelphia. It's only 50 miles
away.
That's true. He may be willing to do an offshoot and come here.
Right.
You know.
You can find out what he's done. Maybe not what he's going to be doing. I'll have to look into that, Kathy.
Yeah, look at that. Just see. It'd be interesting because you can tell that it's a good thing. I mean, the way it's grown, as fast as it's grown. So, well, thank you so much. And maybe
you are welcome.
Yeah. We'll see about next December with the music. We're not going to forget.
We'll work on it.
And want to thank you for being here.
Thanks for having us, co-hosting.
Thanks for being.
I want to just say a few words. Next month, Christine Gordon, who you have not met on the program as yet, she is going to interview me, which is turning the tables a little. Actually, we're going to be interviewing each other because she's an interesting person. She's been around a long time. Mm. And I would like to take the opportunity to thank the people that have been so helpful over the years, because I'm no longer president for Pro Life Berks. We have new president, Megan Nicotra, and hopefully we'll have her on one of these days. But I do want to say thanks and really highlight some of the people who have helped over the years. So we're planning to do that in January. January and February are those months where you can't really count on a guest being here because of the weather. So we're going to do that in January. February, I'm hoping to have Jack Ames from Maryland. We haven't connected yet. I keep emailing and calling, but he's in Baltimore, and I'm thinking we could do it by Zoom so he won't have to travel.
Oh, yeah.
Longtime pro-lifer, real dynamo. Mm-hmm. So look forward to that. And we just want to thank you and wish you all a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. And
We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Happy New Year and Merry Christmas. Good night.
Pro Life Berks on BCTV is underwritten by Tom Schaefer RV Superstore.